I'm Kylie Arendell, registered dietitian with Houston Methodist Wellness Services. Sugar is important for the body in many reasons. Basically, sugar is going to be your body's energy source. So whenever you have carbohydrates that you eat from different foods and beverages, you're going to be digesting them into sugar in the body, and then the body's going to use it in whatever capacity it needs it to. There is some naturally occurring sugars that are going to be found in different types of fruits, vegetables, dairy, even honey and those types of other sugars. But there is also added sugars, which aren't necessarily the greatest source of sugar. You're not going to get the vitamins, the minerals, those types of things that you would from naturally occurring sugars found in fruits and vegetables and dairy. There's no clear direct evidence that shows that sugar is to blame for hyperactivity in children, for example, but some children do react that way from sugar. For adults, though, it is a little bit interesting. There can be direct ties between how much sugar you have and how sleepy you feel later. So if you think about your 3 o'clock p.m., you know, kind of slump where you're just trying to get through the rest of your day, maybe lunch was 2 or 3 hours ago, that's a result of low blood sugar, and that can make you feel sleepy. There is going to be a carbohydrate total intake that you'd want to kind of aim for throughout your day, and then an added sugar kind of limit that you would want to not go above. So from a carbohydrate perspective, you're looking at anywhere from 45 to 65% of your calories coming from carbohydrate sources. And that's dependent on how active you are, among other factors. From an added sugar perspective, the American Heart Association actually recommends no more than 6 teaspoons for women per day of added sugar, and no more than 9 teaspoons for men per day of added sugar. Sugar is definitely needed in some ways to keep our body functioning the way it needs to. So it's a good idea to know how much you typically have per day, and then where you should kind of target and where your gap is, and try to kind of work towards the recommended amount of sugar or carbohydrates in your day. So too much of anything, whether that's coming from sugar or fat or protein, can lead to unwanted weight gain. It can lead to risk for disease. So too much of anything can definitely be bad for you.